Hello, my gorgeous plant people. Today I am showing you my Hoyas. This is a video that was requested by Melanie, and a few other people have been asking me lots of questions about my Hoyas. So I am going to attempt to show you all my Hoyas. It's probably gonna have to be a part one and a part two because there are that many and I don't have all day to make this video, and I know you don't have all day to watch it. Let's get started. The first Hoya I want to show you is this one. This is my Hoya Crimson Princess that's living on a moss pole. If I had a penny for every time someone asked me how my Hoya on a moss pole is doing, I would be a millionaire. Probably not, but this is my plant. I put her up on a moss pole probably over a year ago now. If you haven't seen the video how I do that, just click on the link above and that'll take you straight there. But this is her in all her glory. She looks absolutely magnificent. That's her pot there. That's her nutrient solution. Doing really, really well. Now, why did I put this plant up on a moss pole? I don't know. Probably because I could and I wanted to see what was going to happen. I was experimenting. What I have noticed though is that this particular species of Hoya doesn't have as many aerial roots as others that I have seen. And I'm guessing because it doesn't have very robust aerial roots, it actually has not attached to the moss pole. Also, probably because I don't keep that moss pole very moist, but that's a completely separate subject. So, you know, what is this moss pole doing for this Hoya? Nothing. All it's doing is providing support. It's not doing what moss poles traditionally do that we know them to do, which is help the plant get bigger leaves. That's not what this moss pole is doing. That was not my intention. I didn't think it was. I don't know. Who knows what I was thinking back then. But I love the way it looks. Just look at those leaves. They just look like such a pretty picture. So what I'm actually doing with this plant is every time I get those tendrils, the long ones, I'm actually just wrapping it around the pole, just wrapping it around because I want it to be really, really bushy. So that's why it looks like there hasn't been a lot of growth from the last time you saw it. But I just keep wrapping it around because I want it to be really full so that by the time it gets right to the top, it is just going to be a majestic pole filled with my Hoya Crimson Princess, and that is her over there. Those leaves are just doing really well. The plant is loving, loving life. Let's look at something a little bit different now. Oh, this is my Hoya Carnosa Compacta, also called a rope because obviously it looks like a rope. How gorgeous. Just how gorgeous are those little curly leaves. They are really, really thick. It just feels like cardboard. I've had this plant for years. This is one of the slowest growing Hoyas I know. It's taken this long for me to actually get 1, 2, 3, 4 strands of the thing. It just looks beautiful. I love, love, love this plant. I love photographing this plant because I'll put it in a long vase or, you know, pot and have that plant just cascading down there. At the moment, this plant is living in a 14 centimeter pot in my Leca Clables, and you can see those roots there right at the bottom. Really, really happy. This plant has been in this pot for a while and it's just, yeah, not doing too much too quickly, but it's definitely getting there. And I can tell you, it is definitely one of the showstoppers in my collection. And you know, sometimes you don't need the rare, expensive plants to make you happy or to make a statement. All you need are just the common, relatively cheap plants that when they are happy and growing really well, will just bring magic to your space, like this fantastic plant. All I need to do is give it a much nicer looking pot and it will just be beautiful. Next up, let's do another pretty plant. This is my Hoya Hirschkeliana variegata. And ooh, look at what she is doing. My gorgeous baby actually is flowering. That's my gorgeous plant over there. I love her. When I got this plant, it was tiny, tiny, tiny. And I've been able to get it to this point. It's flowering and thriving really well. Of course, this is another one of my Hoyas that's growing in lekker clay bowls. Hoya Hishkeliana Variegata. So as we go along with this tour, I'm just going to say one thing. I'm just going to ask that you guys don't get angry at me, okay? Don't get cross because I might call a Hoya that you know by a different name, by a different name. I don't really keep up with Hoya names. They're renaming Hoyas all the time and I just can't. So I call a Hoya exactly what it was called when I bought it. And if I happen to learn a new name, then I've learned it. But by and large, I'll just call them what they're called. So don't get upset, please. Don't hit me up in the comments and say that's not what that is. I'm just showing you my plants and I hope you like them. All right, up next is my Hoya Melliflua. This is a tiny, tiny plant still, and those leaves are pretty large and they're very, very thick, really living up to its wax plant name. It's still living in a tiny, I don't know what that is, 7-centimeter pot. This plant, I think, was actually a gift. So I'm really happy to see how she's going to go and get bigger as she gets along. So that is my Hoya Melliflua. I don't see anything that is particularly interesting about this plant just yet. I'm hoping either maybe it's got some really interesting flowers, or maybe when it becomes really big and bushy, those leaves really start to pop. We will see. We'll see what my Hoya Melliflua brings for me. Oh, let us do something that I know you guys will have seen very recently. This is my Hoya Australis Lisa. I recently potted it up in my new pot set and I gave it a clear trellis with those fantastic clear clips. If you haven't seen that video, just click on the link above and that'll take you straight to it. But look at her. Look at how magnificent this plant is. Those new leaves have that tinge of red and then they just become such a pretty picture. I've got 3 plants, I think, living in this pot. I've been propagating. When I got this plant, it was really, really tiny. I've been propagating. What I want is, you know, in 2 years' time, this is just going to be a magnificent thing of a Hoya Australis Lisa. I love this plant. This is one of the Hoyas that I just really, really wanted so badly and finally got. So I'm really happy with this plant. Next up is another of my favorites. This is my Hoya Polynura. Look at this one. This is like the mermaid Hoya. There she is. Those leaves are so lovely. And this one has got a little bit of variegation to it as well. So that's fancy. I really like that. But those leaves just do something to me. I absolutely love them. When I got this plant, it was also quite tiny. And I've spent months and months and months propagating. Because what I want is for this plant to actually start to really cascade down. And I just want to have actual rivers or something like an ocean of these plants just trailing down and just looking fantastic. So this little plant is at the moment living in a 10-centimeter pot and you can see those roots there just looking magnificent. The plant is really thriving and loving its time growing in my lekker clay bowls. This is my Hoya Polynura. When I saw this Hoya, I knew I absolutely had to have it. It was a love at first sight. This is my 4-year day kit. Look at those leaves. They are just something else. It's leaves like I've never seen before. They sort of have like a heart shape to them, almost a little bit like a Hoya Carrii, but not quite. They're a bit rounded there. So you can, if you imagine, use your imagination. They look a little bit like a heart, right? But then they've got these veins that are running through there. And it's like a rugged surface as well. Very, very prehistoric. I absolutely love it. When I got this plant, I think it had 3 leaves. So I think it's done really well to actually get a little vine there. And it's got all those leaves going on there now as well. I probably am going to need a trellis pretty soon for this baby. But for now, she's doing really, really well and thriving in my 10 centimeter pot living in my lecker clay balls. Another question I get asked a lot when I show people my Hoyas is where I get these little labels. So you can see this plant has got this label there, and it's got a picture of what the flower actually looks like, which is very, very helpful if you don't know what they're going to look like, which almost all the time I never do, because let's face it, most of us struggle to get our Hoyas to flower anyway. So we're really here for the leaves. But the flowers are just a bonus. But these little labels actually come with the plant. So where I buy my plants in Melbourne is a place called Collector's Corner, Garden World. And I think they're called Paradisia Nurseries. So they like grow lots of Hoyas. They're a great big supplier of Hoyas. And they actually make these. So if you buy one of their Hoyas, it'll come with this little tag, which I find very, very useful. And I know a lot of my American friends are very, very jealous. And I think I've heard people say that you can actually order them. I'm not sure. I have to find out. If you do know if someone can actually order this, please let me know in the comments below. I'm sure lots of other people would like to know. So that, my good friends, is my Hoya Deiki looking stunning. All right, keeping up with a weird looking leaves, I have here my Hoya Villosa. It did have a little tag. I don't know where it's gone. I've lost it. This is my Hoya Villosa. And I know it's also called a Hoya Globulosa, or it is called a Globulosa now and not called a Villosa anymore. Anyway, whatever. But this is it. Look at that. Look at that. This leaf is thick. It is filled with those fantastic Hoya veins that we love so much. But it also has a little bit of tiny hairs on the surface, so it's a little bit furry as well. I just love it. It looks fantastic. This is another one that I've actually got living in the Leafy Brands Ultimate Pot Set with the clear trellis. I think it looks absolutely gorgeous, don't you? This one is doing well. It hasn't flowered for me just yet, and I probably think it won't be flowering anytime soon after that pot change, but I'm loving how it's going. I'm loving how those leaves are just getting bigger and bigger. And this Hoya is happy. This is my Hoya Globulosa. So why do I love Hoya so much? I don't know. They're just really interesting little plants. I got into Hoyas a few years ago, and since then I have just been completely enthralled by them. Let's look at something a little bit different. This is my Hoya Shepherdii, tomato, call it what you want. But this is a new one that I got, and you can tell when one of my Hoyas is new because they're still pretty small, so it hasn't been with me very long. We've just gone through the soil to lecker transition phase, and that is doing well. You can see we've got some roots there, so that plant has adapted really well, and it's got some new leaves as well. So I'm really liking how this is going. But I love those elongated leaves. They are just, they're really thin and they're very pointy, dark green and very, very waxy. I love this Hoya. I can't wait for it to just, can you imagine what that's going to look? I can just imagine a space in my home, you know, maybe like a ledge or something where I've got all these cascading Hoyas. You know, I'll have that one, I'll have this one, a few others that I've got that I will show you. And can you imagine what kind of a picture that would be? It would just be to die for. But anywho, this is my Hoya Shepherdii. And I am loving those little leaves. And I can't wait to see how she will grow. Another tiny Hoya for you. This is my Hoya Bella. Also a new acquisition, as you can see, still living in my tiny 7 centimeter pot. And those are the roots there. Very good adaptation from soil to lecker. And look at her go. She is doing so well. She was actually quite tiny when I got her, but look at her go. The thing I love about this Hoya is those leaves. They're very tiny, quite pointy, and a lovely dark green. And this Hoya is just vining. It was just one bit, and then it's just multiplying. Like, psh, there's another one over there, psh, and then two over there. And then that's just, I don't know. I mean, I would like more. So I'm thinking I'm probably going to have to chop this, propagate and put back in the pot so it actually starts to look bushy and not doing this, because it's just getting longer and longer and I don't know where the heck it's going, but I don't have the space for it to keep doing what it's doing. This Hoya has got the prettiest little flowers and I can't wait to see it flower. When I just got it, it actually had a little peduncle that actually dropped off because of the transition, but there's a small one there. I'm gonna get up and show it to you. If you look over here, you can see that there's actually a little thing coming over there. Those don't look like leaves to me. That looks like that plant is about to flower. Ooh, I'm excited. I'm so excited. There's another one over there. So I've seen two Hoyas flower when they want to. Some Hoyas I've had for years, they've never flowered. This Hoya I've had for probably less than 6 months and she came to me almost flowering and she's flowering now. So you never know what a Hoya is going to do. You just got to be patient and wait. This is my Hoya Caudata Sumatra. I love this Hoya because those leaves are as hard, as firm as cardboard, and they really feel the texture to them. It's quite, it really does feel like cardboard. I love the way the leaves look, like they're quite, look a little bit mottled. It's not a clear green, right? This one is a little bit like my Daiki, I think. It's one of the Hoyas I think looks a little bit on the prehistoric side. The thing I don't like about this Hoya is it's very viney. It's just lots of vines. I mean, I've had this one new leaf over there, but it just tends to be very, very viney. I don't know why, but I guess it will fill out eventually. So yeah, this is my Hoya Caudata Sumatra. Another one that I just recently got and put into Lekka, hence why it's living in my small 7-centimeter pot. But I think the transition has gone really, really well. And it's now just settling into the pot, throwing out new leaves and about to just explode. How do you guys like that? This is my Hoya Jennifer. When I got her, again, almost all my Hoyas, when I get them, they're very, very small. So I grow them from very tiny plants into big ones. And yeah, when I got this one, I was just like, yeah, okay, whatever. But look at the size of that leaf. Huh? It is just insane. Look at the one next to it and look at this one. It is huge. It's almost the size of my whole hand. It is just really, really big. This one is quite big as well. They're firm. You know, you've got that venation going through, not quite as distinct as a Hoya like the Globulosa, for example. But, you know, I think the Hoya Jennifer still holds its own. But this leaf, look at that. Look at that vein over there. I don't know if you can see it. It's like, you know, one of those bodybuilders with lots of muscles and you can see the vein going through there. That is exactly what that looks and feels like. I can actually feel it. Again, growing in my Lekka clay balls, and those roots are going through over there and they're really, really happy. Another question I always get, what happens when the roots go into the reservoir? Nothing happens. The roots are quite happy to live there. Look at that. I don't know how long that's been there, but it's happy. You know how one family of Hoyas has got lots of cousins? Hoyas tend to have lots of cousins, lots of brothers and sisters or whatever. I want to show you one family right now. So this is the Hoya obovata. So when I got this Hoya, it was labeled Hoya obovata H18. It was small, very small. This is where we are today. This is my Hoya obovata. Now, the reason I love the Hoya obovata is that it's got these almost round leaves, right? Look at this one. Look at the size of that thing. It is absolutely insane. And it's got these tiny little speckles as well. Look at that one. I love this one. It also has a little bit of that heart shape, looking a little bit like the Carrii. I think this one and the Carrii are cousins. I don't know. If you know, let me know. I don't know. But they look really, really alike. So this one is just labeled as a Hoya obovata. Nothing else. And remember, this is just stuff I'm reading off the labels, right? I got this one from the Hoya store in Queensland. Now I'm going to show you another Hoya obovata. This is the Hoya obovata, only this one is a Hoya obovata splash. Now, I don't know. It is a bit splashy. You can see Look at this one. This is my favorite leaf. I've been looking at this leaf for years now. It is my absolute favorite. And every time it gets new leaves, there isn't one to match this one. It is beautiful. It's splashy. I'm thinking, though, that my Hoya obovata splash is not as splashy as it could be. And I'll show you why. See, look, this is the normal Hoya obovata. This is the Hoya obovata splash. Now, okay, granted, it is a little bit more splashy, but not a lot. I think it could do more because if you look at these two leaves of my normal Hoya obovata, they look like they belong on this plant. So I don't know. I honestly don't know. This is just what the labels are. See, that label there says Hoya obovata splash. So I don't know. I just say what the label says. I don't know. I'll show you another Hoya obovata. This is another Hoya obovata, but this is the Hoya obovata chimera. Why it's called a chimera, I don't know. I really have not bothered to educate myself about that, so I'm sorry. But there, that's a chimera. A chimera is usually like a hybrid of stuff. I don't know. I haven't read up on it. I probably should, and I will, because I'm now curious. But if you do know why this is called an obovata chimera, please let us know in the comments below. I'm interested. But one thing that I found interesting about this particular plant is that those leaves are a little bit smaller than the normal obovata or the obovata splash. They're a little bit thinner, they're a little bit longer. So I wonder if it's been crossed with something that has longer leaves than a normal obovata. I don't know. Other thing I love about this plant as well is if you look at this leaf over here, you can see it's got a few like almost pink red speckles on that leaf. It is quite fantastic. I love that. That is my Hoya obovata chimera. So we've seen three Hoya obovatas for now. I want to show you a fourth one. I have a fourth one, and this is my Hoya obovata variegata. So you can see that one. It's a variegated version of the Hoya obovata. So you can see it's got that one. Well, maybe not this one. Maybe not that leaf. There, this one there. You can see the inside variegation of that leaf. This one over there has got, this one there has got some inside variegation as well. A little bit on that one as well. This plant could do better, but there's actually a story I have about this plant. And that is that, you know, not all Hoyas need the same amount of light. Some Hoyas don't need as much light as others do. And there is such a thing as too much light. This particular Hoya, I believe, got too much light. So if you look at this side of the plant, this side over here, these leaves are a lot paler than the leaves on this side. And that's because this side of the plant was exposed to a lot of light, whereas this arm of the plant, this one over here with these darker green, was further down and covered up by other plants. So it wasn't as exposed as these ones. But also, this is the part of the leaf plant that doesn't really have that inside variegation. So I don't know. I think we needed a middle ground between what this was getting and what this was not getting to get exactly the kind of look that we were going for with this plant. So I don't know, too much, too little, I don't know. But this is my Hoya obovata variegata. So this is one of my absolute favorites. This is my Hoya latifolia alba marginata. I think this one also has a new name. I don't know it, I don't care. Look at this. Look at that leaf, white on the outside. You've got that green there and you've got those red edges. I mean, does it get better than that? I don't think it gets any better than that. This Hoya is just loving, loving, loving it. This is it living in its lacquered clay balls, 14 centimeter pot. At this point, I want to address something actually. So I like to put my Hoyas on a trellis. And that's only because if you know Hoyas, if you've seen them grow unencumbered, they just grow everywhere. You've got vines going in all sorts of different directions and they're all intermingling with each other and they're all just loving each other. It's insane. And they go everywhere. I don't have that kind of space in my home, so I try to control the way they grow. hence I put them up on a trellis and I can easily control them. Also largely because I grow my plants in Lekka, and if I just let that happen, anytime I try to do something, I'll have Lekka clay balls everywhere. So someone said to me, when you're putting your plant on a trellis, you must not have the vine facing down like this. So I've got this one. This is actually a vine that's growing. You can see the teeny tiny leaves over there and it's facing down. Now, I have heard this before, actually, and I thought, well, okay, that's great. And I'm thinking this has probably got a lot to do with plant tropisms. So yeah, I know it's slightly a big word, but plants gravitate towards certain things. So for example, when you're growing a plant, you've got a plant in front of a window or away from a window, let me say. If you've got a plant away from the window and the window's over there, the plant is going to start going over there because that's where the sun is. That's what it needs. So it's gravitating towards that area. It's tropic towards that area. That's where it wants to go. That's a phototropism. It's heading towards the light. Plants also have tropism to do with gravity, for example. So when you put a seed in the ground, the plant knows that the roots need to go down there and the shoot needs to go up there. That's a tropism thing. So it doesn't matter whether you put the seed upside, you know, sideways, right way up, wrong way up. It always sort of gets to where it needs to go. And I'm thinking, and again, I am not a botanist. I am not a horticulturalist. I'm just doing my brief reading and my brief botany class when I was at uni, and I'm thinking that I have done this to quite a number of my Hoyas and I have never had a Hoya stop growing because it was facing down. And I'm guessing because of the tropism, the plant knows what it needs to do. It knows where it needs to go. So despite my best laid plans of putting them down, this is probably going to end up there somewhere. So this is just my way of controlling it. And the plant still ultimately does whatever the heck it wants, which is absolutely fine by me. So we all get along just fine. And yeah, that's a little thing from me. Whether it's, I mean, if you've got something to add to that, please let me know in the comments below. Because like I said, I'm not a botanist. I'm not a horticulturalist. I don't know whether what I've said is true or not. I could just be talking rubbish. Anywho, next up is my Hoya Green Jungle. This is interesting. This is different. This is not normally a kind of Hoya that I would buy, to be honest, because in my mind, it looks a little bit boring. It's a very generic. You've just got just normal green leaves, like a Carnosa type shape. Nothing much going for it. I think it's just going to make a really lovely bushy plant. I don't know. I mean, part of the exercise of doing this video actually is trying to figure out which plants I want to keep and which plants I want to get rid of, because this Hoya thing is becoming a bit insane and I need to get rid of some of them. So I'm looking at this Hoya Green Jungle Green, and I'm thinking maybe you might need to go in a giveaway. What do you think? Let me know in the comments. Do you think I should keep this plant or should I get rid of it? It's cute though. Look at that leaf. It's so cute, you know, and I love the green. It's not that dark kind of green. I don't know. I might just keep it. This is my Hoya Arcboldiana. I love it. Look at that. See, now this is my kind of Hoya, right? I love leaves that are a little bit different. They're a little bit weird. This one is really long, jagged edges, rough edges. I love that. The texture is amazing. And look at that dark green. And you can see a little bit of, you know, those veins going through there. It looks fantastic. But also look at what those flowers are going to be when it eventually flowers for me. Ah, I cannot wait to see what that is going to look like. It is going to be amazing. This is definitely one I'm keeping. I'm not getting rid of that. It's tiny, so I've just got it. But you can see this is obviously a new leaf and you've got that vine going up over there. So this plant is truly well on its way. Well, sometimes not everything goes according to plan. This is my Hoya Calistophylla. I don't know. There were like two leaves over there. Those leaves are now gone. It just got yellow and died. It's still living in this tiny pot. And I don't know. I don't know. I mean, you've seen my Hoyas, right? I don't really have a problem with Hoyas. So when something like this happens, I'm like, it's on you, plant. This is not me. You should have worked harder. I don't know. But yeah, this is my Hoya calycifilla. I'm going to keep it just to see what happens. But I'm thinking I probably need to get a new one. This is the point at which you go and grab yourself a new plant. And that's exactly what I'm going to do because I love that plant. I want it in my collection. Those leaves are to die for. Those are the kinds of leaves I like. They need to be with me. This is crap. This is my Hoya Loheri. Look, I'm going to be honest. I do not like this Hoya at all. I don't like those leaves. I don't know why. Actually, hang on, scratch that. These new leaves aren't looking too bad. They look nice and pointy. I did not like these old leaves that were like little stumps. They just weren't doing it for me. And I've had this plant for a really long time. I've had it for more than 2 years. I think maybe more than three. I don't know. I've had it for a really long time. It was one of my very, very first Hoyas when I started collecting Hoyas. And it's just, oh my gosh, it's just, it's been a dud. That's all I can say. Maybe it's redeeming itself. I was actually going to give this away. I was. But yeah, I think it has actually redeemed itself because this was definitely going in the giveaway pile. But I think I might keep it because I like it now. This is my Hoya Loheri. Ah, loving this. This is my Hoya Carnosa Compacta inside variegation. You can see that this plant is variegated, but on the inside of the leaves. There is a Hoya Carnosa Compacta outside variegation, which I used to have many moons ago. That plant died on me. One of the few Hoyas that I had that died. I reckon it was infected from the start, which is why it died. But I've never replaced it. I don't know why. Probably because these plants take so long to grow. It's so annoying. Just like its friend, the big one that I showed you earlier, this is my plant. I've had it for years. I'm getting one, two, there's another one that's coming out here. So there's going to be three of those blocks of that plant. And yeah, it's living in my 10 centimeter pot. It's just, you know, it's just like, whatever, I'm going to do what I want, when I want, and you're just going to have to wait for my gorgeousness. I'm like, yeah, okay, fine, whatever. But that variegation on the inside just brings an added touch of glamour. Okay, I got this plant. I don't know where the label is. It must have fallen off. I have no idea what it is. Absolutely zero idea. I mean, obviously it belongs in my collection because look at those leaves. They're gorgeous. They're absolutely fantastic. It's got those fabulous veins running through those leaves and it's growing really well. You can see all those new leaves coming up there, but no idea what it is. If you know what this Hoya is, let me know please in the comments below. I love this plant. It was one of my very early purchases. Me and this plant we've grown up together, loving life in Lekka Claybles. Look at it. Those leaves are just fantastic. This, by the way, is what I used to know as a Hoya Acuta. I think it's called a reticulata or something like that. I'll have the name up there somewhere. Those leaves are so, they're as waxy as they look on screen. Trust me. And look at that. They're so thick. They're so beautiful. And I love all the varied variegation. Look at this one, completely white. Then you've got that one with, they're all so different. They're all just little works of art. This plant actually has flowered for me in the past. It's not in bloom at the moment, but yeah, I'm loving how it is loving life. And that, my friends, is my Hoya Acuta. Now this is a Hoya I've changed my tune about. Look at that. This is my Hoya Sangi. I think it's a Hoya Sangi. Another one of my very, very, very early purchases. I was very much in two minds about this Hoya. I was not liking how it was going. I just didn't get it. But now, look at it now. It has filled out and it's absolutely magnificent. This is another one I got from the Hoya Store Australia in Queensland. And it's honestly just the one plant. Look there, it's right there and it's just cascading down. What I should do actually is propagate. I should propagate and put more. Fill that pot up a little bit more so there's more of it just cascading down. It hasn't flowered for me yet, at least as far as I know anyway. Sometimes I just find random blooms, you know. You don't even know that a plant is about to bloom and then you're just like, oi, where'd that come from? But yeah, I'm really loving this one. And now that I can see the potential, I want to get a variegated one. I've seen the variegated ones. They look really, really nice. And I'm thinking, yeah, I might want to get myself one of those. But this is me who's actually saying to myself, I'm not going to buy a Hoya this year because I have way too many. It's never enough, is it? We'll stick to flowing Hoyas. This is my little Hoya Serpens. This is another one that I've had for a while and I absolutely love. Also another one that I do need to propagate and get to fill out that pot a little bit more because I think it would look so much better if there was more of them. This plant flowers for me all the time. It is just really happy-go-lucky. And it's beautiful. I also love how those leaves are just, they're just the cutest. They're small and they're round and they just look so amazing. Look at the teeny tiny ones. They're just so, so pretty. Hoya Serpens just doing its Hoya Serpens thing. This one here is my Hoya Nol Nok. Obviously, I'm saying this wrong, so just read what I'm writing up there. I'm not going to say that again. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Look at that. Look at the size of that leaf. This plant is just going insane. Look at the back. It is beautiful. I am completely speechless. This is the kind of Hoya that rocks my boat, for sure. Look at that. It's, oh, it is brilliant. I cannot even tell you. I recently got this plant, but look at it there. It's vining away. There's new leaves. It was pretty small when I got it. I think probably was like two leaves or something, but it is now thriving. Understood the assignment and just getting on with it. I love it. I love it. Love it. Love it. Living in my 10 centimeter pot. That's my nutrient solution there. This plant is going to be a showstopper. Next up is my Hoya Crinkle. I absolutely love this plant. This is another one that I've had for some time. And I think the last time I saw this plant, I was talking about how you can have a Crinkle 8 or a Crinkle 6 or a Crinkle whatever. And I finally decided that mine is a Crinkle 8 because it's got four of those dimples on the leaves. 1, 2, 3, 4. So you count how many dimples your plant has on the leaves, and that'll determine whether it's an 8 or a 6 or a whatnot. So I decided that mine is a Crinkle 8. But the thing that I absolutely love about this plant is, you know, it was just green, right? It was just a normal crinkle, green, green, green. Then all of a sudden, this happened. And I'm like, where is this variegation coming from? Where are these splashes coming from? And what's really weird is that it hasn't actually continued. If you look at these other leaves, it's not really there. So yeah, something happened on one side of the plant. I don't know what. I'm not complaining because it looks really beautiful. Look at that. But yeah, that's my Hoya Crinkle 8 doing its thing. And again, like I said, this plant has been living in this pot for quite a number of years now. So you can see those are the roots there at the bottom. It's quite firm. Doesn't need anything doing. I don't need to repot it or anything. It's quite happy to live there. Those roots are very happy to live there. So that is my Hoya Crinkle 8, which I think is a slash Hoya Crinkle 8 splash. Next up is Her Majesty herself. This is my Hoya Crimson Queen. Now, this is a spectacular plant. Look at that variegation there. You've got the white edges, you've got the green leaves there, and you've got those red stems looking so beautiful. But what makes my plant even more regal is check out this part of the plant, that those leaves are just pink and white. They're literally just pink and white. Take a look. It looks absolutely fantastic. And every time, without fail, every time I show this plant, people say, oh, those leaves are not going to last. The leaves are going to drop off because they're white. I'm telling you, these leaves have been here for more than 2 years. And it's not like they're getting replenished or anything. They're just there. Maybe one or two have died off, I'm guessing because they're just old. But yeah, this plant is absolutely loving life in the Lekka clay bowls, doing his thing. This is Her Majesty, my Crimson Queen, and she's just beautiful. Another thing I love about this plant is, look at this leaf over there. It's pinched right in the middle. Look at it. It's amazing, isn't it? So gorgeous. I am so loving my Hoya Crimson Queen, living in Lekka clay bowls, growing really well. Has not yet flowered for me, and I would love to see that sometime. Alrighty, this is my Hoya Purpura Fusca. There we go, look at the size of that. I love those, like Hoyas that have like really, really big leaves. I just dig them. I really, really do. There's just something about big stuff that I like. Did I actually say that? Okay. Yeah, look at that. It's just beautiful. I love this plant. This is a new leaf over there. It's really, really soft, actually. It's still hardening off. So yeah, this one as well. That's really, really soft as well. And then look at that teeny tiny new leaf over there. This plant is one of my faves, and I think is truly one of Hoya's royalty. One of the most popular plants that does so, so well. This is a Hoya Matilde. Look at that. I love those little round leaves. Bigger than the serpents, a lot bigger than the serpents. If you look at the serpents, that's the serpents there. That's the Matilda. They're quite so much tinier than the Matilda ones, but similar shape. And this plant is just prolific. It just vines everywhere. There's so many vines here. I was literally putting everything together yesterday just so I could be ready for this video today and just trying to tie everything down. But the other thing this plant does is it flowers like crazy. It has been flowering for me. You can see there, that's where I've got all the spent flowers. Although I do have to tell you, you know, we all love Hoya flowers. We want our Hoyas to bloom. But actually, nobody tells you that Hoya blooms are actually quite annoying. They're very annoying because this, you know, they're over there. And then when they're done, they just fall everywhere and they just make a mess. They make such a big mess. It is insane. And for me, who's growing my plants in semi-hydro, I've got Hoya flowers everywhere in my reservoirs and I have to go and pull them out. It's really annoying. But I still love to see them. So Hoyas, don't listen to me. Just flower. Flower at will. I'm not sure when I'll do it, but I will show you my Hoya Matilde splash. Now that is a plant to behold. So this is the normal Matilde. I'll show you the Matilde splash. It is not here because I didn't bring it down for this particular video. That'll have to be in part two. Okay, I gotta confess. I've got this plant over here. I don't have the plant label in there. I have no idea what this plant is right now. I might have to go through all my archives to find out what it is. But right now, I'm drawing a blank. It is some kind of a gorgeous variegated Hoya, obviously. And it really looks a lot like the Akuta, right? But I know I don't have two Akutas, so I don't know what this is. And the leaves of the Akuta seem to be a lot, you know, longer. They're tapering more than this one. And this one seems to be a lot more dark green than this other one. So yeah, I don't know. Maybe by the time I'm editing this video, I'll find out exactly what this plant is. But anywho, I still love it. This is definitely a Hoya after my own heart. It is beautiful. I love those leaves. Look fantastic. And all it needs to do now is flower. I think it's completely understood the assignment. It's grown and off. All right, hopefully I'll have a name for you. This is one of my prize and joy. This is a Hoya Carrii reverse variegata. Look at this leaf. Have you ever seen something so beautiful? And there's another one behind it. So this one, the one that you're seeing here, and there's another one right behind it, and that one. These are new. So I've got the, I think when I got this plant, it was like 3 leaves or 2 leaves, right? And there's just one stem that's going all the way up, and just decided to get leaves right at the top. So this is all blank, but you can see as well, look at those area roots. This is a plant that gives a lot of area roots. So remember how when I was talking about my crimson princess, the one that's on the moss pole, that it doesn't have a lot of area roots. This is exactly what I was referring to. So a plant like this one, an obovata, has a lot of area roots. The caria, the normal caria, has a lot of area roots. So I'm wondering, maybe it's plants that have got, you know, much thicker leaves, because these leaves are really, really thick. They're really hard. They're very succulent-y like. So maybe it's plants like them that have more area roots and, you know, probably would benefit more from being on a moss pole. I don't know, but I am loving this plant. I love the variegation on there. It looks absolutely stunning. And can you imagine what this plant will look like in a few years? It will be absolutely amazing. I will show you what the normal caria looks like. I think I've probably got an elbow caria here as well. I'll show you that one too. Here we are. This is my elbow caria. This is a tiny, tiny plant. But see, this is exactly what I was talking about. It also has those crazy area roots that the other reverse variegata had. So you can see the elbow has got that white on the edges and you've got that variegation on the inside. I'm guessing that's why they call it reverse. This plant has, oh my gosh, it is so slow growing. It is absolutely insane. It is, yeah. If I were buying this plant again, I'd probably just go for a big one, to be honest with you, because it's taken everything to watch this plant get one leaf in 6 months. It's just completely insane. Yes, it's beautiful, but it takes so long. So if you can get a big one, I highly recommend getting a big one. I love this gorgeous baby. This is my Hoya Incresata Moonshadow. Look at that variegation. It is absolutely divine. Plant is fining over there. Those are new leaves. This is another one. When I got it, was pretty small and it is transitioned really, really well to Lekka. That is that plant. And this one is actually not living in my normal submerged setup where I've got the pot sitting inside the nutrient solution. It's actually a wick setup. You can see that's my wicks over there. But look at those roots that have actually grown into the reservoir. Look at them. Look at that. That's a root there. It's just absolutely beautiful. I love it. I just love growing my plants in semi-hydro. Look at that. Gorgeous. Doing really, really well. This is another one that's really going to need a trellis very, very soon. And I'm thinking probably one of the leafy brands, clear trellises, might do the job really well here. I'll keep it in this pot because that looks really cute. Just put a trellis and watch it thrive. You can tell I have a type, right? This is my Hoya Susie Q. Oh, Susie. I love my Susie. I absolutely love her. When I got her, she was tiny as. Look at her now. Oh, my Susie. I just love my Hoya Susie. I couldn't tell you. My Susie Q is perfect. This plant is perfect. The variegation, perfect. All my favorite things. Whites, greens, pinks, and reds. Oh my, the shape of those leaves are just, look at that, look at that. This one's almost like folded in, living in a 14 centimeter pot in my Lekka clay balls. And I'll show you what those roots are doing. So this plant has been living in this pot for some time. You can see, those are the roots there, right? I have no reason to change this over. All I needed to do now is flower. This one here is a little bit different. This is my Hoya Silata. I've had this Hoya for a long time, one of my earlier Hoyas. And the reason I got this Hoya is because those leaves are furry. They've just got this little hair on the surface of the leaves. It feels a little bit like it is so beautiful to touch. The thing about this plant though is, oh my goodness, it is so viney. If I had to unravel it here, it's just gonna would be everywhere, literally everywhere. I quite like this one. You know, I'm sensing a theme here. I haven't actually decided to get rid of any Hoyas. This was part of the process that I was meant to be going through. So I'm not doing very well. This one here is my Hoya Fungi. Ah, this is a Hoya with some funky leaves. Look at that. It's not even straight. It's just like, you know, I can be whatever shape I like. I can have as many veins as I like. And my leaves. Edges can be as jagged as I like them to be, and each of my leaves is going to be as different as I like them to be. Oh my goodness, look at the size of this one! Talking about Hoyas gets me really excited, so I'm sorry if I'm way too animated, but I love this Hoya. I love, love, love this Hoya. It's just, I love how it's so dark green. There's just something about dark green, you know, that just really does it for me as a color. Nothing else to do with this plant apart from just wait for it to flower now. And it'll just keep getting bigger and bigger. This is another one that's been in this pot for some time now. And you can see those roots are just doing their thing. The plant is happy. All I need to do is make sure I give it the light that it needs, make sure that that reservoir is always got nutrient solution, and let it do its thing. Last but not least for today is my Hoya Sunrise. Another one you would have seen if you've seen my video where I actually potted up into this gorgeous white pot and gave it this fantastic clear trellis. This plant, I am expecting lots of things. No pressure on you, little plant, but I am expecting a big bushy plant with lots of sun stressing because that is what a Hoya Sunrise is known for. Look at that, it's already started. You can see some of that red pigmentation coming there. I'm not sure if there's some over there. No, it's just, there's a little bit over on that leaf over there. But you know, it's still young. I recently just got it, so I should probably give it a break and allow it to settle in. And yeah, once it starts growing, I'm really expecting that sun stressing to come because I want my Hoya Sunrise to look like Kevin's of Hakuna LaPlanta. His plant looks like this, so you need to look like that. That is what I need from you. So, anywho, I have been talking for a very long time. I will see you in part two.